Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.3, Problem 3. This is Section 5.3, Problem 3. It says Colin and Joanne borrow $385,000 to buy a house in Mattapoisett. If they get a 30-year mortgage at 3%, what are their monthly payments, and how much interest do they pay? So, this is a loan amortization question. And the formula is P, the monthly payment, equals A, the amount borrowed, over some fairly big brackets that have a numerator and a denominator. In the numerator, you have 1 minus 1 over 1 plus R over M to the M times T power, and in the denominator of the brackets, R over M. It's a big formula. So, fill it in. P equals A, the amount borrowed, which for this particular problem is $385,000. That's not necessarily what the house costs, that's what they borrowed, so they may have put something down, but that's the borrowed amount. And you're gonna have, underneath the $385,000, some brackets, and in the brackets you'll have, in the numerator, 1 minus some fraction, and the fraction will have 1 over 1 plus R over M. So the R is the rate as a decimal. So for this problem, the interest rate is 3%. As a decimal, 3% is 0.03. And in the denominator M, which for a loan problem is the number of payments made per year, which is 12 monthly payments. This is very common for a loan. Not the only value for M, but the most common one. And that 1 plus R over M has an exponent of M times T. So again, M number of payments per year is 12. T number of years for this problem is 30, because they have a 30-year mortgage. Again, that's probably the most common type of mortgage, so they have all kinds of others. And in the denominator of the brackets, R over M again, 0.03 for the R, and 12 for the M. Close the brackets. And that's how the formula fills in. Now we have to do the computation. As usual, we have parentheses. You need to do your work in parentheses first. So a lot of it is just gonna stay the same from one step to the next, and we'll just do a little at a time. So the top of the brackets, I'm still gonna have the 385,000. And then in the brackets, in the numerator of the brackets, I'll have 1 minus 1 over, some parentheses that have 1 plus R over M. The R over M is 0.03 over 12. So that division comes out to 0.0025. Again, I can do those conversions pretty easily. If you don't see it or you think that's what it is but you're not positive, just use your calculator. Do 0.03 divided by 12 equals, and the calculator will definitely tell you it's 0.0025. And there's a plus, a 1 plus in front of that 0025. So 1 plus 0.0025 is 1.0025. And that 1.0025 is in parentheses. It's raised to an exponent of m times t, which for this problem is 12 times 30. 12 times 30 is 360. And in the denominator of the brackets, I still have r over m, which is 0.03 over 12. Same result, 0.0025. And that gets it started. So the next part of this formula that I have to simplify is the 1.0025 to the 360th power. So I'll do that. And when I do, I'm going to have 385,000 on the very top of the formula. Again, underneath that, there'll be some brackets. In the numerator of the brackets, I'll have 1 minus 1 over, and let me see what the answer for that is. It'll be 1 minus 1 over 2.456842211. Then in the denominator of the brackets, I still have 0.0025. So in the numerator of the brackets, I have 1 minus 1 over 2.45 something. Let me calculate the 1 over 2.45 something in the next step. So the next part of the formula will look like P, the payment, equals 385,000 over the brackets. Now, the numerator of the brackets has 1 minus 0.40702654. And the denominator of the brackets has 0.0025. So, now, the top of my bracket, so numerator of the brackets, has a subtraction. Let me perform that subtraction for the next part of this. So when I do, the result will be P equals 385,000 over the brackets. In the numerator of the brackets, I'm going to do 1 minus 0.40702654. Which gives an answer of 0.592973453 in the numerator of the brackets. In the denominator of the brackets, I still have the 0.0025. So to finish off my work in brackets, I have to do the division 0.592973453 divided by 0.0025. Which will give me P equals 385,000 divided by the brackets with just one value in it now, 237.1893815. So the last thing I have to do to get my monthly payment is divide 385,000 divided by 237.1893815. And the calculator gives me an answer of 1623.1753. So this is the point in the problem where I want to get rid of some of those decimals. I only want two places after the decimal because this is in terms of money, how many cents. So after the decimal I have 0.175 something, so that's enough to make it 1/8 or 18 cents. So the monthly payment is going to be $1,623.18. So they pay that every month for their mortgage. And the second part of the question is how much interest do they pay? So again, they're going to pay this every month for 30 years. So there's 12 months per year, 30 years. There's 360 payments of a little over $1,600. So the total they pay back to the lender is 360, the number of payments, times 1,623.18, the amount of each payment. So the total paid back to the lender is, let me do that multiplication, the total paid back is 584344. Calculator says 0.8, so it's 80 cents. Again, I like to think of it in terms of money. So $584,000. So whoever gave the loan, they loaned out $385,000. They're going to get paid back $584,000. So it's almost a $200,000 difference. So let's subtract away the $385,000 that went to whoever it was that sold the house. And because they have to get that up front, the lender has to have that money liquid, as they say. So let me subtract off $385,000. So the total in interest is $199,344.80. That's a lot of interest. It's not as much as it seems, actually, because 30 years is such a very, very long time to pay it back. That's what makes the number so big. It's not as bad a deal as it seems. But that's the total in interest. As the interest rate for the mortgage gets higher, a lot of cases you pay more in interest than you pay for the house. But right now, as mortgage rates are lower, it's not quite as much, but it's still a lot.